what is the Liskov substitution principle, the L in solid?
So the Liskov substitution principle states that objects should be able to be replaced with their subtypes without affecting the correctness of the program, of the system.
So what is an example of the Liskov substitution principle in practice?
So if you have a client component, let's say, that depends on a cache protocol.
Right. So the cache protocol is the type it depends on.
Exactly. It's the type that depends on. Then it shouldn't matter if the client interacts with a subtype of the cache protocol.
Okay.
Being perhaps an in-memory cache or a core data cache or something different, right?
In-memory, it doesn't matter.
Right. It doesn't matter, yes.
Well, it shouldn't matter.
Exactly.
Right? If you have a good abstraction, it should not matter which subtype you are talking to.
Yes. Yes, exactly.
If it does matter, you are violating the Liskov substitution principle.
Yes.
So you should be able to replace an instance of an object with another one of the same type or subtype and not break the system. That's
yep.
it.
That's what Barbara Liskov stated.
And it sounds obvious, but you look around your system and you see a bunch of violations of that principle.
Yep.
So let's have a look at a violation of the Liskov substitution principle.
Right. So I think the one of the most common ones is that when you inherit or conform to a protocol and you just don't implement all methods, or rather you implement the methods and, you know, you have like a fatal error in there, something that can stop the execution of the program, something that will make the client reject the call, right?
So let's say you have a protocol cache that has two methods, add and remove.
Right.
And you have an implementation that can only add, can never remove.
Right.
So you implement only the add method, and the compiler is going to force you to implement the remove one.
Yes.
And you implement it, but you set a fatal error saying, not implemented, don't invoke this method. Well, you have an interface that says, I implement two methods, but you only implement one, and if you call the other one, it crashes.
Yes.
So you're not implementing the protocol at all.
Yes, exactly. That's exactly right.
So you should be able to inject other instances to clients of the protocol, and they should be able to call all of the methods in that protocol or any kind of abstract interface, and it should work. It should not crash because you invoked a method that they were not supposed to. If it's not supposed to, it's not a subtype. The method should not be in the protocol, maybe.
Again, mindfulness. Are you typing fatal error somewhere just because you're inheriting, or, you know, Xcode makes you implement this protocol stub?
Yes.
And you say, well, I don't want this, thus fatal error or something, you know, like some sort of weird behavior that perhaps is going to break the application, then you're violating the Liskov substitution principle.
And that normally happens when you have a very difficult to implement interface.
Right.
Let's say you want to implement this interface because you want to pass this instance to a client,
mm-hmm.
but the interface has 20 methods.
Right.
But I only care about implementing two or three. Well, if that's the case, you should create a new protocol.
Yes.